everyone. It is Monday, October 13th in the year of our Lord 2014. How are all you doing out there? I am doing awesome as always. Wicked awesome. It's Blues Monday, October 13th. Oh, yeah. And folks, today's unofficial sponsor of our show is my amazing friends, Jim and his better half, Cindy Skinner, of the amazing Killer Beer. Folks, Killer Beer is absolutely amazing. You see this? Here, let me give you a better example. Oh, yeah. Perfect for tailgating. Made of wood, strong, sturdy. Even comes with a freezer pack. That's right. Keep your six adult beverages nice and cold while you're tailgating, ready to watch the Patriots destroy people like, oh, what, like they did against the Buffalo Bills yesterday. So, yeah. Chilla Beer. Check them out. Our good friends, Jack and his better half, Cindy Skinner. Granbury, Texas. There's your contact information. And these folks are so amazing, they even struck a deal. I was able to help get their page to over 100 likes thanks to you, the viewers out there. And I got this wonderful Boston Red Sox fan zone Chiller Beer box for free from them. Yes, they are amazing folks. And I highly encourage that you go check out Chiller Beer. Get yourself some beer. Let me get yourself a good box. Keep your beer nice and cold. Perfect for football season. Well, speaking of beer, bring it out, Robert Blues Monday Beer Consumption Apparatus. Good old Route 66. Get your kicks on Route 66. Let's bring out a great beer. Harpoon Pumpkin UFO. That's unfiltered offering. 5.9% of absolute exquisite wicked awesomeness out of good old Boston, Massachusetts, the Windsor, Vermont. Amazing stuff. Power building apparatus, pump technique. Here we go. Not a big pop on that one, but that's alright. 45 degree in the regular big suction apparatus right over the keyboard. Too bad just that damn good. Haven't scored a drop yet. Never have, never will. So tell the man behind the bar, B-E-E-R. Cheers and beers to all of you persons that say Germany pies is dangerous. Beer is good for you. Yep. Like my good friend Chris May of Philo Liquor said, this is indeed the best pumpkin beer you're ever going to have. A plus all the way. Chris May, Philo Liquors, check them out. That's right, they're awesome. Wicked awesome. And, yeah. Chris, cheers the beers, my friend. And to your wonderful lesser half. I mean, lesser half? Oh, like she's a Canadian fanny. Ah, your wonderful better half, Stephanie. Stephanie May. I do love the fact that your Montreal Canadiens are definitely the lesser half, all right. They're down 7-1 to the Tampa Bay Lightning. Oh, Canada, indeed. You got to give some love to our neighbors up north. But you can give the Montreal Canadiens a big fat GFY. I can't stand them. I'm a Bruins fan, even though they lost today. Ah, lost to the Colorado Avalanche. Horrible. It's all right, though. I still represent all my home teams. Right, Red Sox, Patriots, Celtics, and Bruins all the way. And Chris May, I know you agree with me on that, my friend. Ah, all right. We got so many birthdays, folks. We need to get moving. Right off the bat, a posthumous happy birthday to my awesome grandfather, one of my true heroes in life, my grandfather, Lou Karras, on my mother's side. He would be 95 years old today. He passed away at the ripe old age of 93, February 4th, 2013. And then my grandmother, his better half, Betty, passed away 71 days later at the age of 90. They truly lived for each other 72 glorious years of marriage. 7 kids, 20 grandchildren, 32 great-grandchildren, 5 great-great-grandchildren when they passed away. Just an amazing couple. And I know they're celebrating in heaven. I know he's celebrating in heaven. And she's spoiling him like she always did. So, Grandpa, cheer the beers and rest in peace. He'd be 95 today. Unbelievable. All right. Now, my good friend Courtney Wright, my own niece. Niece Courtney. A wonderful sweetheart of a lady. Who I know from good old California, the land of fruits and nuts, otherwise known as Southern Oregon, now living in Oklahoma. That's right. Northern Texas, pretty much the same state. Courtney, my dear, happy birthday to you. How you doing? Hope you're doing well. And I know your wonderful lesser half, Anthony, would be spoiling you if he could, if he was there right now. But he's off making money in West Virginia. Why West Virginia? I don't know. Interesting. But, hey, he's making money for you because you got to take care of the old lady, the better half. That's right. And you're far from an old lady there, niece Courtney. Believe me. You're barely more than half of my age, kid. But Courtney, love you, girl. Happy birthday to you. Have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. And by golly, cheers and beers to you. My man Justin Thibodeau. Now here's a legendary badass safety inspector on the job site. My man Justin, who I know down here in Texas, otherwise known as Southern Oklahoma. That's right. Justin, happy birthday to you, brother. How you doing? Hope you're doing well. I'm sure you're living it up, partying it up right here, right now. Do it up. I'll do it with you. Let's drink together, shall we? Have a wicked awesome day. Party hard and enjoy. Celebrate like 1969 minus the acid. Cheers and beers to you. Squeaming. Ah, next on the list, my good friend Micky Willis. Yo, Micky, what's going on? How you doing? Fellow mafioso on the old Mafia Wars. And I'll be on there as soon as I get done recording this here show. Micky, my friend, always appreciate the help and happy birthday to you. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Now, this lovely lady is born the exact same month, day, and year as my friend Micky Willis. The lovely, amazing Jacquie Rapko, the pride of Massachusetts, and a wicked, hardcore, no bull Boston Bruins fan all the way. Boy, do we hate those Montreal Canadiens. Yeah, we lost 2-1 to the Avs today, Colorado Avalanche. But don't worry, Montreal Canadiens, they just got crushed by the Tampa Bay Lightning of all teams. Well, they're not undefeated anymore, and Jacquie, there's a birthday present for you, huh? So yeah, let's drink together. Happy birthday to you. Have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. And then my good friend, fellow Masonic brother, Marion Cameron. Brother Marion, how you doing, my friend? Hope you're doing well. Haven't heard from you in a while. Love to hear from you. I'll be going home on vacation for Christmas and New Year's. I'm hoping that we'll have something going on with the Marine Lodge, Falmouth, Massachusetts. Love to see you. Been a long time. But happy birthday to you, my fellow brother. Have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. My good friend, Dan Deslorias. This guy. Badass mamma jammer of a man. Good old Martha's Vineyard Island. And a fine outstanding graduate of Martha's Vineyard Beach High School class of 1993. Married to the lovely, gorgeous, amazing Jade. I knew her as Jade Barwick for so many years. Ever since she was about that big. I've known her longer than you, Dan. But you know her better than I do. Why? Because you're married to her. And she's probably spoiling the hell out of you right now. Jade, how you doing, girl? Fine, I'll say I'm graduating Martha's Vineyard Beach High School class of 1994. And probably spoiling her wonderful birthday boy, Dan. I missed the two of you big time. Hey, I'll be coming around in a couple months. Hope to see you both. And Dan, happy birthday. Have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. My good friend, Gene Eagle. Gene Eagle, another Mafia Wars legend. And happy birthday to you. How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Let's get on here, ice some fools, and have a lot of fun. Teamwork makes the dream work on the old Mafia Wars. That's why it's important that we help each other out. We do it every day. Oh, yeah. We get stronger and crush the opposition. Gene, my friend, have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Ah, such a good beer. Yo, J.R. Robertson, a great leader of men, women, and it's that I know from jolly old England, bubble-chasing, badass legend of a man. Living in his beloved Charlotte, North Carolina, where he gets the root for his North Carolina Tar Heels, because he loves Duke as much as I love the Yankees. Yeah, we know how that goes. JR, my friend, always loved playing in the fantasy college hoops basketball tournament every year. It's a lot of fun. And didn't I finally win one? Yeah, I did, didn't I? So I'm currently the defending champion.
Yeah.
Let's hope I put up a better title defense than my Boston Red Sox did with their World Series title. Oh, that was terrible. Terrible how they defended it. But JR, my man, always a pleasure chat with you. Happy birthday to you. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. My good friend, Neal Lemon. A wonderful, wonderful man I know from Oklahoma. A family friend of the legendary Bill Bichet family, the Bichet family, the Lemons. Just awesome folks. Neal Lemon, awesome guy. And happy birthday to you. How are you doing? Hope you're doing well. And brother, hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Miss playing the old Farmville with you. I know I haven't been able to get on much. Been way too busy for that. My man Gary Vidrine. Badass crew dog. That I know from jolly old England. Gary, one hell of an awesome guy. Hard working man. A great man indeed. Brother, always a pleasure hearing from you. And happy birthday to you. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Party hard and enjoy. Rock on with your bad self, brother. And cheers and beers. And the final birthday of the day goes to my dear friend, Spike O'Haley. Always smiling, always a positive attitude. Absolutely beautiful lady that I worked with down here in Yeehaw, Texas. Otherwise known as West Louisiana. Sparkle, my dear, happy birthday to you. Hope you're doing well. Looks like you are. Working with my good friend, Jen Vesper. A real, real sweetheart, I believe. Two great ladies working together. If that ain't wicked awesome, I don't know what is. And you are wicked awesome, Sparkle. And happy birthday. Have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. All right. Folks, we've got ourselves a wedding engagement announcement. My good friend, Phil Hayes. Badass engine repair man. That I work with down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as Northern Mexico. Phil, getting married to the lovely, gorgeous, amazing Magen Harrison. Well, happy engagement day to the two of you. Hope you get married soon, and hope it lasts for at least 72 years, like my grandparents. How about that, huh? At least that.
Yup.
Remember, communication is key. Without communication, a relationship will never succeed. Okay? I promise you that. I know, I'm the love doctor, that's what I'm talking about. So I want to say happy engagement to the two of you, and congratulations from the love doctor to you, and I say cheers and beers. All right. Well, well, well. Trivia question. Sadly, nobody got it. Only my good friend John Heller gave it a shot. And I thought more would guess. According to Steve McQueen, what was his favorite beer? Well, you know it's old school. Steve McQueen died December 7th, 1980, unfortunately, at the age of 50, cancer. Well, it was Old Milwaukee. Old Milwaukee! Yuppers, Old Milwaukee. According to Steve McQueen, that was his favorite beer. Boy, I wonder what he would think about today's microbrews, you know? He'd probably be very impressed, I would hope. Steve McQueen, of course. Frank Bullitt, Lieutenant Frank Bullitt in the 1968 classic auto chase movie, Bullitt. Love that movie, one of my all-time favorites. All right, folks, we're long overdue on this. I've got 3 weeks worth of Fan of the Week. That's right. You the fans out there that do the most that you can to keep this show and page going. And from the week of September 22nd through September 28th, which was mine and my love goddess's wedding anniversary, by the way. Yes, 12 years of absolute exquisite, wicked, awesome marriage. We had a man that shared the show and page quite often, more than anybody else. He's one Fan of the Week more than any other man ever. That's right, the legendary badass from Japan, our good friend, George Seckman. George, my man, congratulations. Fan of the Week winner, September 22nd through 28th. You know what that means, right?
Oh, yeah.
Big love doctor salute to you.
Oh, hell yeah.
Kampai, my friend. Cheers and beers. And then from the week, September 29th through October 5th, In that time, I moved from my love goddess and I and little princess Delilah, along with some many friends that helped us out. We moved from our old house that we were renting to our own house that we bought. The house that you see behind me. Yes. And through that, our good friend George Seckman shared the show every single day that I had one air. George, you nailed it, brother. Fan of the week, 2 weeks in a row. If that ain't wicked awesome, I don't know what is. That is a huge, bona fide, double mammer jammer love dot to salute to you. Oh, hell yeah. And a big hearty cheers of beers to you, George. Dude, you are truly méchant génial. French for wicked awesome. You know what I'm saying, eh? Don't take it a beat. Oh, Canada indeed. That's right. Cheers and beers. And then our most recent Fan of the Week winner. This lovely lady has been featured numerous times as our real babe of the day. She has also won Fan of the Week before. And she brought us 25 new fans. She shared the page. She recruited a bunch of friends. We got her page, Jen Conley, to over 8,000 likes. She, in turn, got my page from 1,340 to 1,365 likes. Like that. Incredible. In like a day and a half. Jennifer Conley. Jen Conley, my dear, congratulations. You earned this week's Fan of the Week. By God, you done did do it again. And a huge love doctor salute to you. Oh, hell yeah. Jen Conley, my dear, a big hearty cheers and beers to you. And to all your good friends out in Wichita, Kansas. One of my biggest followings in the world. Congratulations, Jen. You like Smith Barney. You made it the old-fashioned way. You earned it. With that said, how about some additional shout-outs? I've got enough time for one very special additional shout-out. To my man, Brian Shaven. Brian, my friend, I loved your post today. I really do. And I want to say, happy Thanksgiving to you, my friend. Absolutely. Because see, folks, it is indeed happy Thanksgiving Day in our beloved country up north of the United States. Good old Canada. That's right. So happy Thanksgiving to all my Canadian friends, eh? Congratulations. Every day should be Thanksgiving. Thanks for giving. All about giving to each other. You're looking out for each other. And Brian Shaven, an amazing guy and a media legend over at thesportsnetwork.ca. That's right, tsn.ca. Check them out, the largest Canadian sports network. Amazing stuff. He works there. Toronto, Ontario, Canada. Brian Shaven, wicked hardcore Toronto Blue Jays fan, wicked hardcore Toronto Maple Leafs fan. That's right, brother. It's hockey, baby. My Bruins look like shit right now, but don't worry. We'll be there. We'll be there. I believe. And speaking of believe, you do believe in your Buffalo Bills, but not against my New England Patriots. Thanks for giving us a victory. Yeah, see, Thanksgiving. Thanks for giving us a victory. I appreciate it. Brian, I appreciate you and your friendship. You're a hell of a guy, man. Cheers and beers. All right. So there you have it. I think it's time we get to our hunk of the day. And there's a plethora of celebrity birthdays for today. So let's bring out, you know, it is Blues Monday. You want kind of a little tough guy kind of thing. So how about tough guy, badass actor Paul Burke, huh? I don't even remember who requested Paul Burke. I know somebody did a long time ago. For whatever reason, I had a bunch of pictures of Paul Burke. And I don't even know why. And I was looking through. I thought, all right, well, maybe I featured him in the past. Apparently not. So why not, Paul Burke? Veteran actor. Because he's also cool. That's why. Why not? Hey, how about some celebrity birthdays for today? Famous birthdays. Like Jerry Rice, wide receiver, predominantly San Francisco 49ers. Greatest wide receiver in history, and I don't think there's any doubts about that. He's put up numbers that I don't think are ever going to get beat. I really don't think they're going to get beat. I mean, he played for 20 seasons and played at a very high rate for so long. Jerry Rice, 52 years old today, and he looks like he can still go out there and beat most people today. Dude's in incredible shape and a class act all the way. One of my favorites, no question about it. Another one is 52 today, and she's looking damn good for her age. John Travolta would know, definitely. Kelly Preston, oh yeah, Kelly Preston, 52, and by God, she has gotten hurt. She has shown some great exposure over the years, and I love it. How about singer Ashanti? 34 years old today and looking fantabulous. Margaret Thatcher, legendary tough girl, prime minister of Great Britain during the Reagan era. Her and Ronald Reagan, I mean, two of the toughest leaders in the world at the time. Two of the greatest, in my opinion. Margaret Thatcher, born this day 1925, passed away in 2013. She is definitely missed. So is legendary Boston Celtics basketball player Paul Pierce. Number 34, Paul Pierce, the enforcer. A legend. No longer with the Celtics, but he'll always be a Celtic in my eyes. Paul Pierce, 37 years old today. Sacha Baron Cohen. Sacha Cohen. Borat. That's right. He's Borat, isn't he, if I remember correctly. Actor. 43 years old today, Tisha Campbell. Oh, I loved her in the TV show Martin. In fact, she goes by Tisha Campbell Martin. Hyphenated names. Not a big fan of those, but Tisha Campbell, I'm a fan of hers. Oh, yeah. And she's 46 years old today and looks fantastic. Naked City. That's where Paul Burke was the most famous TV show, The Naked City. A classic. And look at that, wearing a fedora with a suit. Doesn't that look so much better when you wear a fedora with a suit? Why don't people do that anymore? I think it needs to come back. Seriously. When you wear a suit, for God's sakes, wear a fedora. It just looks professional. It's the right thing to do. You're already trying to look sharp. Why not make it even more sharp? How about Paul Simon? Yes. Simon? Paul Simon, of course, the Simon and Garfunkel. Paul Simon, 73 years old today. Marie Osmond, the legendary Osmond family. Out of Utah. That's right. Utah, Donnie and Marie. Marie Osmond, 55 years old today, and she is still gorgeous today. Yeehaw country singer Rhett Atkins, 45 years old today. So is Massachusetts native and figure skating legend Nancy Kerrigan. Nancy Kerrigan, why? I'll never forget that. Because she was stabbed by that stupid bitch, Tonya Harding. Well, all right, Tonya Harding had the hit put on her. Oh, that greasy, skanky little troll, Tonya Harding. What a, ugh, gross. But Nancy Kerrigan, definitely much better looking and 45 years old today. Sammy Hagar. Of course, he took over from David Lee Roth of Van Halen. Sammy Hagar, badass, legendary beast, 67 years old today. Doc Rivers, former Boston Celtics head coach, former NBA player, and a damn good one. Doc Rivers, 53 years old today. Jerry Jones. Whether you love him or hate him, Dallas Cowboys owner Jerry Jones, I think he gets too involved in everything. But I give the man credit where credit's due. He is committed to winning, and he will do whatever it takes to win, and I do appreciate that. I respect that. If he didn't care about winning, he wouldn't be spending money. When an owner's trying to win and spend money to do it, you got to respect that. Even though Jerry Jones is kind of a douchebag and a meddler, at least he cares. He's 72 years old today. Sean O'Donnell, former NBA, NHL hockey player, played with the Blackhawks, the Bruins, the Kings, the Philadelphia Flyers, and, yup, can't remember right. The Mighty Ducks. The Anaheim Ducks. Most famous with the Kings, though. Sean O'Donnell. 43 years old today. Legendary comedian Lenny Bruce. This guy got arrested for obscenity many, many times. Him and George Carlin were two of the true pioneers of adult comedy. Along with Red Fox, of course. I consider the big three, Lenny Bruce, George Carlin, and Red Fox. Those are your pioneers. And Lenny Bruce. Born on this day in 1925, passed away much too young at the age of 40 in 1966. Ann Thorpe, the torpedo, the pride of Australia. Legendary Olympic swimmer, 6'6" and an absolute fish in the water. Ann Thorpe, the torpedo, 32 years old today. Damon Wilson, who remembers Sanford and Son? Lamont Wilson, that's right, the son of Red Fox in Sanford and Son. Damon Wilson, 68 and doing great. Legendary free safety, number 20, Brian Dawkins, Philadelphia Eagles. 41 years old today. By the way, they retired his jersey. Me, to this day, when I think of number 20, I still think of Andre Waters, one of the greatest and most hard-hitting safeties in NFL history. Summer Sanders, former Olympic female swimmer, female Olympic swimmer, commentator now, hottie, 42 years old today. Paul Potts, remember him? He was on, was he on America's Got Talent or Britain's Got Talent? It was one or the other. Paul Potts. Kind of a dumpy-looking, heavier-set guy. You know, jacked up teeth a little bit. And then he sang opera, and it was incredible. Simon Cowell and the crew, their jaws just dropped. Paul Potts, incredible singer. 44 years old today. Doing well now. Very happy for him. And then, speaking of legendary singers, how about legendary gospel singer Shirley Caesar? Shirley Caesar, 76 years old today and still going strong. So there you go. There's your celebrity birthdays for today on Beer and Song of the Day. Big and A, let's have a drink. All right. Well, time for my favorite part of the show. We've got the babe of the day. And speaking of the babe of the day, my goodness, I gotta be careful. Because this girl was not afraid to get naked. She got nudies out there. She's so cute. We're bringing out, it is Blues Monday, and it doesn't get much more deep than this, folks. Recorded at Stovall's Plantation in 1941. A young man that was only 26 years old at the time, a virtual unknown, by the name of McKinley Morganfield. He went on to become one of the greatest bluesmen of all time. They say he invented electricity. Went up north to Chicago, invented electricity, recorded for Chess Records from 1947, from the early beginnings, right on through 1967. The legendary badass Muddy Waters, this is his first song he ever recorded. Stovall's Plantation, 1941, Country Blues, as we feature the lovely, gorgeous, amazing Janelle Evans, our babe of the day, on Beer and Song of the Day, Vegan A. Whoops, there you go, you got some free boobies. Couldn't help it. Free assets. All right, that's enough of that. Janelle Evans, listen up and drool. This girl's not afraid to show it. I think she was on the TV show 16 and Pregnant or something like that. Yeah, that's what it was. 16 and Pregnant, MTV show. Had a kid at 17. Now has another one. She's doing well. She really is. Very happy for her. She did buy boobies. She must be doing well. She could afford boobies. She could afford boobies. She could afford tattoos. Uh-oh, but she can't afford that. Mugshot. Yeah, she's like 4'11", 5 feet tall. I think she's 4'11", it looks like. Smiling in her mugshot. That's kind of weird. 5 feet tall with her hair. Busted again. And again. Kiss, kiss. This girl gets in trouble a lot. Alright, 5 feet tall.
Apparently, she's a little troublemaker.
Be like my woman now.
Okay, I've already shown that one once. I'm not going to show it again. Listen to that guitar. Stovall's Plantation, Mississippi. She's pregnant there. I think she looks better, a little thicker personally. BB before boobs, apparently. Face. Bang! Every time I see duck face, I say bang. Great song. The legendary McKinley Morgan Field, later to become Muddy Waters. First song he ever recorded. John and Alan Lomax recording session. Without the Lomaxes, man, we wouldn't have blues the way we do nowadays. Because those guys went all over the place, all over the country, all over the world, looking for great music. And that's pretty great right there. Hey, on this day in 2010, the Australian dollar reaches the highest level in 27 years against the U.S. dollar. Not good if you're American, great if you're Australian. Oh. After boobs, that's what they became. I kind of preferred her... not into huge, you know, I don't really care. So there you go. Whether you like biggins, littleins, it doesn't matter. Hey, on this day in 1997, Andy Green's jet-powered car reaches a record, 749.69 miles per hour. Andy Green of Jolly Old England broke the sound barrier on land. Wow. On this day in 1996, New York Jets kicker Nick Lowry, former longtime Kansas City Chiefs kicker, breaks Jan Stenerud's NFL field goal record at 374. Jan Stenerud, back in the day, 373 was the record. Jan Stenerud, the only kicker in the NFL Hall of Fame at the moment. That will change. I'm convinced of that. Adam Vinatieri, someday. You'll see. Or more than Gary Anderson. That should happen, too. On this day in 1993, Mighty Ducks win their first NHL game on this day in 1990. The Target Center in Minneapolis, Minnesota opens. On this day in 1982, the International Olympic Committee restores two gold medals from the 1912 Olympics to Jim Thorpe. Jeez, better late than ever. I just realized I failed to mention a wedding anniversary. On this day, October 13th, in the year of our Lord, 2007, a couple of very wonderful people got married. Our good friend Melodie Hassel and her wonderful lesser half, Bob. Bob and Melodie Hassel got married. 7 years of marriage today. Bob, Melodie, congratulations. You're over the hide part, as they say. They say the first 7 years are the toughest. You've made it through that. You're doing well. I'm very proud of the two of you. Congratulations. Sorry for the late shout out. But you know what? I'll make up for it. I'll give each of you the Love Doctor salute. Cheers and beer, 7 years of exquisite, wicked, awesome marriage. Keep it going strong. Mm-hmm. All right. On this day in 1972, incredible story if you've never read this. The day that Summer Sanders was born, Uruguay to Chile plane crashes in the Andes Mountains. It was carrying the Uruguay soccer team. And 16 of 45 people survived. Folks, the story of survival is unbelievable. Not all were killed immediately in the crash. Some were killed days later in an avalanche. The movie Alive from 1993 with Ethan Hawke, fantastic movie. Did a very good job of portraying what actually happened. So, yeah, you need to check out the movie Alive. You need to read about the... plane crash. They literally had to resort to cannibalism to survive. Folks, I don't know about you, but if I had to do that to survive, I would. For life in itself is a blessing. And sometimes you got to do what you got to do if you truly want to live. On this day in 1971, first World Series night game. Yeah, no kidding. It took all the way to 1971 to play the first ever Major League Baseball World Series game at night. Now you never see them during the day anymore. Too much revenue, you know. It's all about the almighty dollar. Anyway, Pittsburgh Pirates beat the Baltimore Orioles 4-3 in that game. On this day in 1960, speaking of the Pittsburgh Pirates, one of the most famous home runs in history. Quite possibly the most famous home run in history. I can't think of one that beats this. Well, Joe Carter did pretty good, huh, Brian Shaven? Screaming. Well, listen to this. Pittsburgh Pirates, Bill Mazeroski, bottom of the ninth, leadoff home run, beats the New York Yankees 10-9, Game 7 of the 57th World Series. The Pittsburgh Pirates beat the New York Yankees in the World Series because of that home run by Bill Mazeroski. Wow. On this day, 1955, first edition of L'Express publishes in Paris, France. On this day, 1953, burglar alarm, ultrasonic or radio waves, patented by Samuel Bagnuolo. On this day, 1947, here you go, hockey heads, Brian Shaven. You'll like this one. First NHL All-Star game played. The All-Stars beat Toronto 4-3 in Toronto, Ontario, Canada. See, back in those days, you used to have a bunch of All-Stars play against the team that they were playing in. So, yeah, like, you know, if they were playing in Boston, the All-Stars would have played against the Boston Bruins. I know they've done it against the Chicago Blackhawks. Back in those days, that's how they did it. Amazing. And sometimes the team themselves would beat the All-Stars. Pretty impressive. On this day in 1923, Angora, now we know today is Ankara, becomes the capital of Turkey. On this day in 1915, the Boston Red Sox beat the Philadelphia Phillies 4-1 in the 12th World Series. On this day, 100 years ago today, the Boston Braves sweep the Philadelphia Athletics. That was the first sweep in World Series history. That's the only World Series that the Boston Braves won. They won in 1957 as Milwaukee and 1995 as Atlanta. Maybe they should move again so they can win another World Series. But 100 years ago today, the Boston Braves won the World Series. Also, 100 years ago today, Garrett Morgan invents and patents the gas mask. Something I think we can all appreciate, especially when somebody cuts loose a nasty, deadly fart. On this day in 1884, Greenwich is established as the universal time meridian of longitude. Greenwich, England, 0 degrees. There you go. On this day in 1860, first aerial photo taken in the United States. It was from a balloon. Where at? Boston, Massachusetts. And finally, on this day in 1792, two amazing things happened. The first ever Old Farmer's Almanac is published. I have been reading the Old Farmer's Almanac for over 35 years. My father gets it every year. I get it every year now. Love it. Absolutely love it. And also on this day in 1792, of course, George Washington lays the cornerstone of the Executive Mansion, which we know today. Thank you, Teddy Roosevelt, for renaming it yesterday in 1901 as the White House. I will drink to that. I will drink to the rest of the end of the show. Drink with me right here, right now. Empty as the brain cells of an average Montreal Canadiens fan, eh? Folks, you know what time it is, right? Damn right, Reverend Dr. B. Folks, time to make like a fetus a head out. So everybody take care. Wicked awesome night and day. Peace be the journey. Don't do anything I wouldn't do. Don't do drive my spray drink. Or you might kill yourself or somebody else. And drink it or driving is dumber than being a Yanks fan. And what's dumber than that is written for puke infested goober schnitzels like Eli.
Imitate Tom Brady.
The way you played last night, you weren't even as good as freaking Mike Brady of the Brady Bunch. Dude, you sucked ass, Manning. Or men slapping women, or animal abuse, or racism, or people who watch on bets, or fake friends, or anybody that supports the fans, or is a member of the Westboro Baptist Church. Things like that are just plain stupid, and definitely deserve a big fat TFY. Folks, am Ronnie out. See you all tomorrow. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.
Bye. Bye.
Longer than I wanted, but a good show nonetheless.